Let's try to understand the theory of team building based on the Tuckman model, and it is related to one of the very famous Hindi film. I'm sure that all of you have seen this film. It is Chak De. The first stage in the team formation is forming stage. This stage is characterized when the people just join the project. When you join the project, what is your concern? You want to know why I am here. You want to know why, what this project is going to achieve. And you also want to be, or you are basically more independent about yourself. Just remember the scene in the movie when the girls start introducing themselves. The first girl will say, "I am Balbir Kaur from Punjab." The second girl will say, "I am Komal Chatala from Haryana." So they are still in their own independent view. It is the job of the project manager to orient these people towards a bigger goal for which the team is formed. It is the job of the project manager to share the information, to communicate with them so that they become comfortable with the project. He should have an open discussion with them so that all their doubts are resolved. The next stage in this model is storming. This is the time where people start working on the project and the project manager is expecting some deliverables for them. And when you start working and when the deliverables are expected out of you, most of the time you will lead into the conflicting situation. Because of your role, because of the authority that is given to you in the present project, you will try to relate this experience with your previous experience and that may lead to the conflict. Remember the movie? One of the girls who was the captain of one of the state team, she is reluctant to play in this team because she says that, "I was the captain in the previous team. Unless you make me captain, I cannot play in this team." So that type of conflict will come in the real life situation. And this is where the project manager has to be very careful and he has to take some action so that the project team passes through this phase very successfully. Now, once this phase is passed, then we are getting into the phase which is called a norming. This is where the people will get adjusted to one another. They will start trusting one another and they will start delivering the project deliverables. They will also enjoy working in the team. They will have fun in the team and they will start sharing the information with one another. After this, we now graduate to the next stage, that is called a performing stage. The project manager should take some extra effort to take the team to that level of performing. What are the characteristics of the performing team? They are committed to the work. They are committed to the goal for which they are here to achieve. And the team commitment is higher than their personal issues. Remember the movie? There are two girls in the final. They do, and their problem is that they do not want to pass the ball. And what happens? When the coach gives instruction for the final match, he will not talk about this problem to the girls. He will only talk that. Just remember that dialogue. 70 minutes. These 70 minutes are the most important minutes in your life. And he says that, "Today I am not going to tell you how to play the game. Today you are going to tell me how this game must be played." That means the team resolves their problem on their own without the help of the external person. That is the performing team. And the last stage in the team formation is adjourning. This is where the team members are released from the project as the project is about to close. And if you relate this whole five stages to this movie, I'm sure you will never forget these concepts.